Hello. Now today we'll discuss the last topic of the chapter, solid state, that is magnetic properties. Every substance have magnetic properties, and these magnetic properties are due to the presence of electrons, and each electron behave like a tiny magnet, and this magnetic property is expressed in terms of magnetic moment. And this magnetic moment of electron is due to the two type of motions. One is orbital motion, in which each move around the nucleus. Another one is the spin motion, in which each move around its own axis. In this diagram, this electron is moving around this. This is the nucleus, and this is electron is moving. And in this case, this spin motion is shown. This is the direction of spin is in this direction. This is the direction of spin motion. Electron being a charged particle and undergo these motions can be considered as a small loop of current. That is, when a charged particle is under motion, it can be considered as a small loop of current, and this have a magnetic moment. Each electron has the two type of magnetic moment. This is the permanent spin magnetic moment and orbital magnetic moment. And magnetic moment is expressed, this magnetic moment, M-O-M-E-N-T is not there. This magnetic moment is expressed in Bohr magneton. And one Bohr magneton is 9.27 into 10 to the power minus 24 ampere meter square. Now, on the basis of magnetic properties, substances can be classified into the five categories. Paramagnetic substance, diamagnetic substance, ferromagnetic substance, antiferromagnetic substance, and ferrimagnetic substance. Now we'll discuss one by one. First of all, paramagnetic substance, or these substances show the paramagnetism. This is due to the presence of unpaired electron. Remember it. If any substance is paramagnetic in nature, it means it may have one or more unpaired electrons. And these type of substances are weakly attracted by the magnetic field. When they are placed in the outer magnetic field, they will attract toward the magnetic fields. This is the example is given. This is paramagnetic material, and these are the magnetic lines. If you place, then this show the attraction toward, weakly attraction toward the magnetic field. Like this is a vacuum where nothing is there in this magnetic field. But when a paramagnetic substance is placed, this is the paramagnetic substance, then these lines will attract towards this substance. This is a magnetized, these substances are magnetized in a magnetic field in the same direction. And as soon as we remove the external magnetic field, they lose their magnetism. Examples are like O2. In case of, we have discussed the molecular orbital theory of O2. O2 is diamagnetic, O2 is paramagnetic in nature. This because it having the unpaired electron in its antibonding molecular orbital. The same way, these are the paramagnetic. If you write the electronic configuration of these ions, you will find that one or more than one electron which are unpaired is there present in these substances. That's why they are paramagnetic in nature. Now we can say, in case of magnetic field, the magnetic moment of each electron is randomly distributed like this. When we apply the magnetic field, this magnetic moment of electrons are aligned in this particular direction. That's why they show the magnetic properties. Next one is diamagnetic. They are weakly repelled by the magnetic field. Now just see this diagram. There, nothing is there in this magnetic line, but when we place the diamagnetic substance, these magnetic lines are repelled. Like example are water, NaCl, and C6H6. They are weakly magnetized in the magnetic field in opposite direction. And this is shown by those substances in which all the electrons are paired. All the electrons are paired. That is, there are no unpaired electrons, no unpaired electrons. Then these substances are the diamagnetic substances. Pairing of electrons cancel their magnetic moment and they lose their magnetic character. Now, ferromagnetism. few substances like iron, cobalt, nickel, gadolinium, CrO2 are attracted very strongly by a magnetic field. Substances are known as the ferromagnetic substances. Substances can be permanently magnetized. It is a common experience that when any iron piece is kept in contact of a magnet for some time, this iron piece again become a magnet. So we can say after removing the magnet, that iron piece will behave as a magnet. So that's why we can say these substances permanently magnetized. In solid state, the metal ions of ferromagnetic substances are grouped together into small regions, and these regions are called domains. Each domain acts as a tiny magnet. Now just see, this is the diagram. In this diagram, we can divide the substance into some parts, and in this each part, this is just one small part. This is one domain. This is one domain. This is another domain. This is another domain. This one is the another domain. So we can say, and each domain behave as a tiny magnet. In an unmagnetized piece of ferromagnetic substance, the domains are randomly oriented and their magnetic moments get cancelled, like this diagram is shown. But when we place this substance in the magnetic field, all the domains get oriented in the direction of the magnetic field and strong magnetic effect is produced, like this is the diagram show. Now, magnetic moment of these domains are directed in the same direction. The ordering of domains persists even when the magnetic field is removed and the ferromagnetic substances become a permanent magnet. You can also represent the magnetic moment of the domains in the same direction. They are parallel in like this, same direction, this one. These are the ferromagnetic substances. Now, antiferromagnetic substances like MnO. Showing antiferromagnetism have domain structure similar to the ferromagnetic substance, but their domains are oppositely oriented and cancel out each other's magnetic moment. Like this, this is in this upper, this is down, this is upper, this is down, this is in up direction, and this is in down direction. So they are equally and opposite, equal and in opposite direction, these aligned. That's why they cancel to each other. And its example is MnO, antiferromagnetism. Now last one is the ferrimagnetism. The magnetic moments of the domains in the substance are aligned in parallel and anti-parallel direction in unequal number. Remember it, in unequal number. These are weakly attracted by magnetic field as compared to the ferromagnetic substance. Example is Fe3O4 magnetite. Ferrites like MgFe2O4 and ZnFe2O4. These substances also lose ferrimagnetism on heating. This is a one question. Many times it is asked in the board examination, what happens when ferrimagnetic substance or Fe3O4 is heated? So we can say it becomes paramagnetic. Why this is paramagnetic? Due to randomization of spins. Now, what is the meaning of this randomization of spin? In case of ferrimagnetism, domains are there, but these domains are arranged in the anti-parallel direction in unequal number. But when we heat it, now these domains are destroyed and only random motion of electrons are there. That's why this will convert into the paramagnetic substance. Now this diagram shows the anti-parallel direction in unequal number. If you say this is 1, this is 2, this is 3, and this is 4. This is in the up direction, and this one, and this one in the down direction. So this is in unequal number. That's why this is ferrimagnetic substance. This is all about the solid state. I hope you have understood whatever the topics we have discussed in the solid state. Thank you.